Hi friends, today we are going to see demo on Snowflake table sampling versus table clone. In this demo, we will see in which scenario table sampling will help you versus table clone. If you have not seen my recent blog on same, I would suggest you to please have a look. Please subscribe to my channel for early notification when I publish anything. Let's begin with the demo. So in this demo, I'm going to create a fresh database called table sampling versus clone demo. I have pre-created the order table and the line item table. And the size of the order table is 3.8 GB and the line item is 15 GB. For this demo, I'm going to put off the result cache so that we are not going to use the result cache feature and confuse the outcome of the execution timing for the query. So let me create the database and then let me re-alter the session. So on this demo, I'm going to create a sample table out of a block method. So I'm going to use the block sampling of 3 probability out of seed of 80. And let's see how much time it takes and what is the size of the table it got created on my current database. So hopefully it will get created quickly. We will see over here how much time it takes. So you can see it took around 5.39 seconds to get created. Let's see on the query profile. So when we click on step 2 and when we go on table scan, we will see that out of 332 partition, sampling only sampled around 8 partition and created the table. Now let's refresh on the left hand side. We will see that the database has been created and the table auto sampling also got created. So we will see that the row set is very less as compared to the source of the order table if we see here, but it is more or less around 3%. So 89.9 MB out of 3.8 MB and scanned only 8 partition, right? So if I'm not wrong, it was 8 partition. Now if we query the sample table, let's see how much time it's gonna take. So hopefully it should be also very quick. So you can see it got queried on 4.89 seconds. And if we see that table scan, we will see the table got created out of 15 partition and it scanned the entire table. But because the data set was very small, it was very quick. Now let's see the difference. So basically you have seen that the partition, I mean like the sample table also get created very quickly. Now let's see how the clone works. So now I'm going to clone the order table from TPCS SF100 custom database, which I just created for this demo. And I'm going to clone the order table as order clone. So you will see that this will also get created quickly because here we are not actually creating the table. We are actually referencing the table data from the source database. So you can see that it got created in 892 milliseconds. And in actual, we didn't copy anything. It was just the structure copy. So basically we are not going to pay double, but whenever we do a query on our table in background, it is going to query the source database storage. So now let's execute the clone table and see how much time it's going to take. So as this is being copied on the source order table, even though it's clone, but it's going to reference the source database table storage. So here the when we see the cloning timing versus like the cloning timing of the table creation out of clone, the time took was far less than when you do the table creation using the sampling. But here the difference lies at the time of execution. So when you sample the table, it took more time, not too much, but in comparison to clone, it was taking more time than what time it took for clone a database. But here you are copying the entire data set with a small subset, right, during sampling. But in case of clone, you just copy the metadata and reference the source metadata. So cloning time, when you do a clone, it's faster to clone the table than to sample the table. That's point one. But when it comes to execution, which is the major part of your development data set or development like lifecycle, sample table was very quick because the data set was small based on the 3% probability. But when you copy the clone table, it's actually as good as you are querying the source table. So data set was same, and hence your compute cost will be more. That's point number two. So the comparison says cloning is faster than sampling on the time of deployment or the creation of the table or the objects, but at the time of execution it's going to cost you because you are executing on a bigger data set rather in case of sample table where your data set is very small. So you can see still it's almost 2 minutes 10 seconds. So yeah, so it got completed in 2 minutes 14 seconds. And if we go here, you will see that it scanned around all 332 partition and give you the output of all the rows. So you will see, you have already seen the differences on the query timing, on the execution timing versus the development deployment timing. Now let's see how the aggregate query perform in case of clone table versus sample table. So this is the first query which I am going to run on the clone table. Let's see how much time it takes, hopefully in seconds. So we'll see in 867 milliseconds we queried the table, right? Now let's see how much time it took for query the aggregate value on the sample table. So you will see it took 545 milliseconds. So majority of the time you will see that it took for the execution part. Hence you can see that when you use the smaller data set, your query execution is faster, your development lifecycle is smaller, and whether it passed or failed, your execution or the output of the execution will be much quicker when it compared to clone table. So when it comes to provision an environment, it depends upon whether it's for the development purpose or you need the production data set. So if you need a development data set, go ahead with the sampling concept. But if it's you want a full data set to do the final testing, I would suggest to go for the clone. But the cost will get impact. So when you do a sampling, you pay a storage cost and then you save a cost on compute because the data set is small. But in case of clone, you don't pay for the storage unless you do any kind of change on the table, but you pay on the compute cost because you are working on a bigger data set. Hence compute take more time. So hope now you got a clear vision on which scenario should use cloning table for execution and on which scenario should use the table sampling. So let me revert the session result cache which I changed, and since I have already done with the demo, I don't need this database anymore. So I'm going to just clean up so that I don't pay double. Hopefully you like this demo, and if like the demo, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.